Hi guys, welcome to another episode of my tutorial. From my last episode, every episode will be special. So today I'm featuring the boss of makeup. I call her Tush Boss. So now she wants to carve my brow. When she carves my brow, we'll come back and introduce her properly. So guys, stay tuned. Okay guys, so we are back. So I haven't carved my brow, so tell me what look
amazing. Okay, yeah, so guys, hello, my name is Mikola Lawal, owner of Tush Beauty, and today we're going to be having what we call glam look. Very glamorous, extremely. There's something that will make you look very pretty.
So what do you like to do first?
You know, first thing, I haven't shaved your brows. Next what we're going to be doing is to prep your face. Okay. Prepping the face is really very important, guys. If you want to try it at home, don't ever forget to prep your face. You know that, you know, the weather, Nigerian weather is not easy at all.
So what are we using?
Yeah, for me, I like to prep using my mist liquid, and also I can as well use ponds as well. It's always better for me to like play very safe. I'm starting with the mist spray. You can see this City Color Oil Control Primer. That's what I'm starting with. I'm just going to spray the face from afar. Spray just a little bit. Next thing, I like to use my hand to feel my client's texture.
Okay, for me, I like to use my oil control and pumps first, then I'll spray first.
I like to use my spray first. But I want it to sink into the pores, and then I'll use my oil control. I'm still going to be using my spray after my foundation.
Oh, okay.
So that's what I do. I like this to set in, because you never can tell the kind of skin texture. You know, we're not doctors. We can't actually know until you do your client's makeup. So it's always better to use the spray first and then the pumps. I also like to put the pons right on top of the brows to just give it a little bit of weight.
Sometimes oil comes out.
Exactly. So yeah, that's it.
So with this now, how long do you think my makeup will last?
12 hours. So after that, I'm going to be starting with the foundation.
Okay.
There are different techniques, but for today's glam look, I'm going to be starting with the foundation.
What foundation do you like to use the most?
I love to use the Maybelline. Maybelline Fit Me, Stay Matte, anything Maybelline works for Nigerian weather. So for me, I like to play safe. If I'm not using Maybelline, I'll do Revlon. I'm not using Revlon, I'll use L'Oreal. Okay. Those three are my best.
And
then of course, for the luxurious ones, for the expensive ones, if you have the money, you can go for Black Up, you can go for MAC. Those two are actually very
good. Very expensive.
I have my Maybelline Fit Me. That's what I'm using. So next, first thing I need to do is to, you know, apply foundation. So I'll start from the brows. Apply it on top of the brows. Because I want, this is why I like to apply on top of the brows, is to get that natural feel from the brow. So I'm applying the foundation, I've applied it right on top of the brows, and going towards the forehead area. You know, I like to stipple because I want it to sink into the pore. You're watching me out there, getting the right shade of foundation is really very key. So if you're not stippling well, you have to learn to stipple very well.
For me, I like to apply my foundation with a beauty blender.
It's also very good. You know, there are different strokes to different techniques. Sometimes you're not comfortable using it. Like you are comfortable using the blending brush for the foundation. Some people are not comfortable doing that. I just like to hold my brush and stick. And if you look at it, it's all even. So I'm just tipping to make sure everything is done. So the next thing I do is carry my oil control primer by City Color. You know, if you remember, yes, I used it earlier. I'm just going to spray it again to seal the foundation into the skin. So right now that the face is prepped and primed and there's a foundation, you have to try as much as possible to avoid contact. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is to, you know, set it. I'll set it again. But I want to set it with a powder, but because I'm going to be doing a glam look, I want to like contour and highlight. So I think the next thing I'm doing is to contour and highlight. So using my LA Pore and LA Pride concealer, I'll be highlighting her face. you have to go for a shade that is closer to our, that like two shades lighter.
To my skin tone?
To our skin tone. And our skin tone is like kind of brownish yellow. Like orange, if you want to ask me.
I'm bleaching, I've not finished bleaching. So what can we use?
We're using hair makeup.
Okay.
Concealers don't sink into the skin. That is why they are called concealers, to highlight, to enhance. That's why they can't sink into the skin. So you are the one that will look, you have to make sure that your blending skills from the A list is on point. If you're a pro and you're good at what you're doing, your blending is not nice. It's as good as you not being good enough. So with your blending has to be very enough. Like now, you can see that Aisha has a forehead. So I'm just concentrating on the center of the forehead. Everything depends on your client, depends on who you're working with. If the forehead is small, you have to apply it. You want to make the forehead a little bit bigger. But if the person has a big forehead, you have to like concentrate on the center and then you contour all the sides, edges. The temple, the hairline and stuff. So you can see I've not done anything to the face, I mean to the nose bridge already. And you can see we're not going out of line. The concealer is not way too much, not going far from our skin type. We're still on point. Next thing I'm going to do is apply contour our face as well. Okay, so I like to use the Black Opal Contour Kit. You can see I'm contouring the face now. The temples, don't forget. The temples area.
I'm always in a rush to do this. I like blending.
You know, the highlights are blending, you can't rush. So if you rush too much, you're not going to get the effect. But if you take your time, it's not like you're going to waste the whole time. You just want you to get the right angles. If you know the right angles, you just start blending. I'm not just light a little bit from the side to create more volume for the cheekbone I've created. So I'm using my brush from East Cosmetics. I don't want to make her face look too long. So I'm just going to stop at the center to give that illusion of hair. Yeah. Just use your brush to pull down.
So when you're stippling, you go in between the
Dark line. Yeah, just to blend as well. And then you can use a blending brush to do the finishing. So next thing you're going to do is to use a setting powder. There are different shades of setting powder. I don't like to say banana or whatever, because for your skin type, I like to use something that is closely related to your skin. It could be a setting powder as well. If you don't have a setting powder, don't be afraid. You can get a new powder in that shade. So I'll go for Zara. I'll go for Zara loose powder.
In what color? Zara in what color?
In L720. Zara L720.
I use Chanel color Chanel 1. Color very one. Light, like a white powder.
Oh, no. Wow, that's cool. That tool is really nice. But I like to use the one that suits your skin tone better. That one you're talking
but
about.
But I don't have too much.
Yeah. Okay, that's how you will
and I also
control it.
Yes, and I also set with the powder before I bake.
Before you bake. So if I mean to, this is also baking. If I mean to keep it up, because you know some faces that when you bake, by the time you go back to it, you see wrinkles.
Yeah.
Yes. So that's why if you use a loose powder, you're baking already. As far as that's related to the person's skin tone, you're good.
So how long have you been doing makeup?
I've been doing makeup for close to 11 years now. So really, yeah, close to 11 years. First time I started makeup, I started like, fully like it. And then from there, I thought about it. Okay, I can turn this hobby to business. Let's see how that works. Don't forget I've not controlled the nose.
Yes.
I'm going to be using, this is a glam look, so I'm going to really make it very strong.
But you can either do a powder contour or a cream contour.
You can mix both.
You can do both.
Yeah, you can do a cream contour. You can do a cream highlight. Okay. And then
a powder contour.
But for a glam look, you have to do like a cream highlight. You can do a powder contour if you want to. Usually for the cheap, we're going to just save it in the rubber in there. We have tried to make sure that we don't overdo with the under eye.
So you can check us out on Instagram, Tish Me Beauty.
Okay, yeah. So back to the brows. So here I'm going to be using my Marlboro pencil. I'm going to be creating a natural brow.
I like full coverage. Makeup,
like,
full skin,
glam
brow, yes.
Yeah, if you're doing a glam look, it works too. But right now, what works more is the natural brown on a glam face.
So, you're a celebrity makeup artist, so can you tell us how many celebrities you've done? Well, that's easy if you can count.
Yeah, exactly.
but well, just tell us a few.
Yeah, I've done quite a number of celebrities. And I've done for Omar Wanda. I don't know if you know Omar or me. I've also done for Linda KG, done for Mora. I've also done for quite a number of them. I've done for I've done for Toya Imaku.
Okay.
Quite a number of them.
Very inspiring.
Yeah. So on to the next round.
So what are your experience like with celebrity? Are they different from our normal day-to-day clients?
Well, there's nothing different about them. The difference is that a lot of people know them. They're just like a regular client that are working. But you know, because they have a big name. You understand? So because of that, they try to like very, very carefully who touches their face, who does their makeup. So of course, for their look to be complete, they want the best hands to be doing this. For someone like that, you have to come up with your own game. They're going to be doing their makeup, they have to really know what they're doing.
Yeah.
They are very finicky, they are very, very particular about who does their makeup.
Okay.
But aside that, there's nothing special. Some are very difficult to work with, some are very cool.
Do they like rush you?
Sometimes you need to like learn to be very fast when you're doing their makeup, because most of the time they do it for shows or they do it for maybe interviews and stuff, and then they work with it. You have to find a way to work with their time limits, the time they have.
Manage that. What's the fastest makeup you've done on a celebrity? And how many minutes?
15 minutes.
And who was it?
It was 20 minutes.
15 minutes full makeup.
15 minutes full makeup.
Wow.
She doesn't go on set for a reality show. And we didn't have time.
I think I saw the reality show. Yeah. I watched an episode.
It was 15 minutes. We didn't have enough time. So I've been using my concealer. Any concealer for under her brow. So it blends and just all I want to see is that arc point. Yeah, it's my darling.
Yeah, so I'm
going
so
back to the top. Yeah, going back to the top of the brows. I'm not going to be starting from the beginning because I've already prepped and primed and I've already powdered. So I'm not going to start from the arc point because I want to create that natural look. So I'm going to start from the middle and just a little, just for you to define I'm using Kylie eyeshadow palette. I'll be working with this color. I'm gonna be creating a smoky blue. And a smoky blue.
Yes.
Let's get down to it. So I'm just transitioning. This is what it's like transitioning.
So what are we transitioning with?
Yeah, we're using the same palette I told you about, the modern fashion palette.
Okay.
So now I'm creating a little bit of crease with this too. Okay. Then use my primer. Now I'll go for the oil control LA Pride. I'm going to use my hand to blend it with the primer. So after applying the primer, I'm just blending in between the crease and for it to be as well.
And when you are blending your shadow, it makes it easier.
Makes it easier as well. Yeah, true.
I'll do that
sometimes. So now I'll go for my blue color. And everyone will be like, I think. See if you see the blue color.
It's very nice on the cut crease.
Exactly.
I love it.
So come to the next side.
Your eyeshadow brush is not flat. It's very fluffy.
No, actually, this is not an eyeshadow brush.
Okay.
I'm using like a contouring brush, but I don't want it to pack enough eyeshadow. Like, I'm taking the time. Now I'm stippling it. I'm setting my eyebrow with a smaller brush. I'm using Ezekiel palette. Next thing, I'm going to be using my Kajal, Maybelline Kajal. Okay. So, next thing is to apply the lashes. Let me take my lash. Okay, so, going to the next one. So you can apply, you can use the mascara for your lashes before applying. We've got the lashes from Anika 2.0, Reader Lashes. It's actually my lash lines.
So it's produced by
Tush Me Beauty.
You can hold her on Instagram.
You can hold her on Instagram at Reader Beautiful. Aisha, what do you think about the wigs?
Very, very natural.
Okay.
I don't even feel like I'm wearing any lashes.
Yes.
I don't, truly, honestly. I don't have to lie about it.
I'm going back to the under eye to just for the glam look to be complete. We need to smoke under the eye with that color makeup to create a smudgy look. I don't need to get it precisely for this one. That's to be smudgy. So I'm just creating that. This is the glam effect when you create top. Very clear contour. That's beautiful. For glam, you overdo it.
Looks so different.
So I'm creating more.
I like the way my skin feels so subtle and light.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't even feel like I have any makeup.
And the face is not heavy.
Yes.
That's really like it. So next thing I'm going to do is to apply the bronzer and also apply the blush. Yeah, this blush is nice. It's actually very affordable. Miss Rose. The bronzer from Prestige Cosmetics. So I'm going to give it a soft contouring brush, starting from the center. I'm going to apply it to the crooked bone. And I'm going to also apply it to the cheekbone. Next, we're going to just the, you can just the remnants from the brush now. That's what we're going to just apply to. Just the remnants, you don't take more. Apply to the center of the forehead to give you that glow. Give the skin like hydrating it. The next thing I'm going to do is apply the blush to the cheekbone. Because it's dark skin, you're going to go for something like fuchsia pink, not the light pink for light skin. You're going to go for fuchsia pink, burgundy, orange. That's what works best. So I'm going to just go for fuchsia pink.
I will usually apply my blush starting from my apple of the cheek backwards.
Down. Yeah. That works best for ordinary face.
Oh, okay.
Because you're trying to create if that's what needs.
Okay.
But it doesn't necessarily mean you're
okay. Okay. Then
every day. Yeah. Can you see the look now? It's a glam look. You can feel it even from the way, from the side, you can see like it's really...
Everything is detailed.
Detailed, yeah. It takes for the board. Next thing is for you to blend. Blend in all what you've done so far. Just carry your powder brush, the empty one, and just blend. I'm just going to play with your lip exactly the way it is. I'm going to play with this color.
Okay.
Then the brown. And then great lots of gloss. For the lip, when I'm doing a glam lip, I don't like, if I'm doing too much on the eyes, I don't like doing too much on the lip. And if I'm doing a lot on the lip, I don't like doing so much on the eyes. At the end of the day, it's the skin work that matters. Because you want all the contouring at the right, in the right places, you want all the highlighting in the right places, you want everything popping, you want your bows in the right places, and basically your eyes to pop.
Okay.
Even if you're doing a subtle eyes, you still want under eyes to pop. Something has to come glamorous. So having done all that, next thing is to be very, very soft. So on the lip, so with the lip, I'm not going to be doing too much. It's just going to go naturally. But I'm going to do a lot of gloss because she doesn't really have a big lip. So luckily for me to do. So guys, for the lips, I'm going to be using Avon Lip Gloss in Matte. I have my e.l.f. Prime and Plum. That's what I'm going to be using to prime.
My lips is my favorite part of makeup, so I'm excited.
Alright. So next thing I'm just going to do, I'm not going to play too much with the colors, so I'm going to be using my hands to do and in Tracy, the new BP. Tracy. Okay, let's go back. Put it on the center. Because it's glam look, you want to overdo it. Like you want it to, you want your lips to be speaking. So there you go, your glam look. But before we decide to wrap up, we're going to be giving her the last finish, like spraying the makeup. So here you have it, the glam look. Do you love our lips? So that's it. The glam look. This is just one of the many looks you can do for glam. You can wear this for night, parties, for fashion meetings, for any big events in town.
Thank you guys so much for joining us today. This is a look that I love so much. And also, don't forget that Sushmi Beauty takes classes. She trains people, yeah. DIY and professional training. She does everything.
Our starts next week.
Yeah.
All the details will be on my page.
Just go to Sushmi Beauty Studio and ask all the questions. She has a spa, she has a lounge, she has a beauty salon, and her lashes are amazing and they are natural. Trust me, that's what I've been using from the beginning of my video. This is a very nice lash. So don't forget to click this link in my description box and find our page right there. Bye.